Expectations. It's something I've found recently is like the ultimate silent killer of efficiency and productivity. I've seen so many people in the past couple years just who are otherwise very competent and very good mindset otherwise just be crushed in their endeavors because their expectations were bad and maybe not in the way you'd expect. And it's something that's so easy to change and so easy to fix. You just need to go through the trial and error of trying different expectation levels and seeing where it gets. Hello everyone, my name is Skyline, and recently I've been just dealing with a lot of management structures. Not in the past month or 2 months, I'm talking about 2, 3, 4 years, 5 years, right? 15, 20, 25 different management structures, management groups. And I saw a pattern in that the management structures that presented good expectations of their employees, and we'll get into what a good expectation is in a bit, performed so much better than management structures that had wrong expectations or bad expectations of their employees, even despite any other factor. It was such a big deal. And I got to thinking about it, and somehow my mind connected with people who are in solo queues for matchmaking games like Overwatch or League of Legends or Counter-Strike, and how a lot of times you go into the game and you expect certain things of your teammates, just like you expect things from your employees or your real life teammates if you're working on a group project. And it just having good expectations, regardless of your skill, regardless of if you're a positive person or a negative person or whatever, it can just double your efficiency and how quickly you can climb and learn things, because otherwise everything you do is gonna be tainted, right? If you have a bad expectation. I'm gonna go over the 3 ways that I see most people's expectations skew and why they really don't do any, they don't do you any favors when it comes to actually trying to accomplish something. And the first one is surprisingly popular, and you see it a lot. It's like the no BS sort of way to go about things, and that's the don't expect anything from anyone. Zero expectations. Just assume that no one is gonna do anything for you, like no one's gonna do anything properly, and if you assume that, then you'll be able to foresee any possible scenario and you'll be able to stay on top of anything. That's the idea, right? Don't expect anything. And you've seen people who act like this probably in your daily lives, and you'll know immediately when I give examples that it's maybe not the best way to do things. This is the manager that micromanages. This is the teammate that this is the Genji picker, the widow picker who just picks that hero and then goes off, never says anything to the team, never works with the team. They just try to go and get like quad kills every single fight with no, you know, they do dragon blades after everyone is dead to try to win the fight. Or it's like your friend or your partner, or your teammate who doesn't trust anyone. Like they always, they'll ask you to do something and then they'll check on you constantly, or they'll just assume that you didn't do it, which makes things weird later on when you did do it and they like did a bunch of things assuming you didn't. That's that person. The person who expects nothing. And it's a really easy thing to sort of fall into because it sounds very good, right? If you see a lot of people on even YouTube and various speakers and such say, don't expect anything from anyone, you know, be your own person, be your own boss, blah, 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 whatever. And it does not work because all those examples I gave are examples of people who don't expect anything from anyone. Basically, the result is you just waste a ton of time. You really demotivate the people around you because if someone expects nothing from you, you're probably not gonna do anything after a while. And it's just super, super inefficient. Now let's go over the second way that people's expectations skew. It's pretty obvious. It's the other side, the other extreme. And that's expecting everything from everyone all the time, expecting top tier performance. And I think a lot of people in a lot of contexts understand that this is bad. For example, if you're playing Counter-Strike and you get upset because your teammates don't like do really well every single game and they don't hit like the perfect flash and smoke setup, or if you're playing League of Legends as the AD carry, and you expect your support to always be there, like every single time, always making the perfect play. Like, oh, Thresh, why didn't you throw the lantern and then hit the hook and then, you know, pull them back in like the perfect angle that would have saved me, like as if you were some sort of top 10 challenger pro, right? I think a lot of people understand that that's not a really good way to go about things, but there can be a bit of a twist on it that people do sometimes. And again, going back to this is more of like a management thing of expect 110% from everyone all the time. You know, if you tell someone I expect 100% from you, they're actually going to perform a little bit worse because you're not giving them any headroom. Headroom is important because let's say someone's working on, I don't know, an art project and you say, I expect 110% from you all the time. And so they go in and they do something that's 100%. Well, presumably it can't get any better because it's already 100% of their work. You've really sort of limited them because no one is ever going to do 100%, right? Instead, they're going to do like, I don't know, 50% or 60% or whatever. And they're just going to forget that there is any other 40% above that. So generally I found that expecting everything from everyone all the time, even in a positive way, like, yeah, you got to put 100% effort in all the time. Like that's just unrealistic and it's going to result in people having a skewed perspective of their own work. And like I said, if they feel like doing a little bit better, then they won't be able to because they'll have the idea that they're doing, you know, already 100% all the time. And that's at least in my experience, what I've seen people do when they're told, I expect 100% from you. And then from the person expecting side, obviously no one's ever gonna give 100% all the time. That's impossible. If you're playing Overwatch and you expect your teammates to be gods all the time, you're just going to not play optimally, right? If you expect too little, you're going to wind up overcompensating and making bad plays because you're just gonna assume your teammates are not going to do something that they in reality probably will do. And if you expect too much, you're going to wind up not taking enough into account and not playing safe enough, and your teammates will just obviously not live up to your expectations all the time. But there's a third way expectations skew, and I think that this is by far the most common and the deadliest of all possible bad expectations. That is to expect average all the time, which makes sense, right? It makes perfect sense. And this is something I actually learned. I already sort of had this idea, but it really crystallized when I was playing a lot of Magic recently, Magic the Gathering, and that I would get frustrated because I would always expect average. I would always expect the statistics to line up to be average over a certain subset of games. That's really, you can't approach it. Like in Magic, it's very easy to see because the cards don't lie, like the game is not going to change for you. For people, it can be a little bit more difficult because you can always make excuses and they themselves are living beings who can talk and make excuses as well. But expecting average is basically saying my expectations are going to be wrong half the time, right? Average is 50%. You generally can't afford to only have a band of expectations be right 50% of the time. Average is a very deceptive number because if you play towards average, the best you're going to do is hit 50%, and no one wants to hit 50%. You need to hit 55, 60, 65% on the super top end. You need to hit that high. That's how you climb. It's by being above 50%. So if obviously the extremes are wrong, I think anyone would be able to tell you that. But if average is also wrong, where do you want to sit? Obviously, we're going to be somewhere in between. The question is, if this is average, low, and high, do we want to skew higher or do we want to skew lower? And in my experience, I found the most success, and I've seen that management structures and just people in general have found the most success skewing a bit low. Not too low to where they don't expect anything from anyone, but low to the point where they're expecting the bare minimum. They're expecting the minimum, like, foreseen possible outcome. Because on average, if you expect someone to only be 10%, you're gonna be wrong almost always, right? But you can pretty well guarantee a good 25% performance from someone at any particular given time. Obviously, you'll be wrong sometimes, but I've found that it's much more harmful to skew high and assume better of people because you'll just not think of things and things will hit you in the face and smack you and it'll be really bad, rather than skew low. Because if you skew a little bit low, then sure, maybe sometimes you're being a little bit safer than normal, but it's usually very minor. And it's usually in such a way that doesn't impact your performance too much while still keeping you ready for any particular outcome. You always need to be ready for your teammates or your friends or whoever it is to perform a little bit better than average so you can pick it up. And you can actually see this in advice that people give. I'll go back to the magic example. And there are a lot of times when people talk about whether you're the aggro deck or the control deck and how that might change even in the middle of the game. For example, if you find yourself in a super strong position all of a sudden, just randomly, it might be a good time to sort of throw away card advantage and just push really hard for a couple turns and hopefully win the game. And it's things like that that really push people's win percentage a lot higher, knowing when to push. Because a lot of people in Magic, for example, if they're used to playing safe, because playing safe will get you to a certain extent, if you're used to playing safe all the time and an opportunity arises and you don't push for it, that could be a win that you don't wind up getting. Similarly, in Overwatch, if your team is just popping off and doing super, super well, sometimes if you're a support, for example, or like an Ana, maybe you don't want to be safe in the back line doing like small plays. If they're doing really, really well, you want to get up there and play aggressive and play in a way that would normally be dangerous. But at the same time, you want that baseline to be low enough so that you can sort of account for any situation while still not being so low that you're just assuming your teammates are bots, right? Because if you have, again, I'll go back to a support player. If you assume that your tanks are, if you're in Masters or whatever, and you assume that your tanks are just always going to throw themselves and kill themselves at the enemy, sure, sometimes they do that, right? But if you assume that they're always going to do that and never have any sort of self-preservation at all, then you're always going to be trying to get these crazy, difficult heals off, and you're always going to be trying to be in these aggressive positions to save your tanks who maybe don't need saving, and the results will be a majority of the time, right? Maybe a quarter of the time you'll be right, but 75% of the time, what's going to happen is you'll just be putting yourself in a dangerous position for no reason. And all of this I've been talking about, guys, is only expectations. It's only expectations, how I'm talking about a player who can be good or who can be safe or who can be overly dangerous, and it just depends on what you expect from your teammates. So don't fall into the trap of the don't expect anyone from anything from anyone. Don't fall into the trap of expect 100% from your teammates all the time. Don't fall into the trap of average. Average is almost always the worst thing or like the most deceptive thing in any circumstance. So generally, if your first instinct is to say, oh, well, I'll just do the average, probably not the right answer in any situation, especially not here. Always keep that low to medium sort of 25 to 30% range in a percentile sense of expectations so that you can be ready for people to overperform, but at the same time, you're also ready if they underperform a little bit as well. That's sort of the sweet spot, and anytime I've ever seen anyone have that expected of them, they actually perform better. For example, if a manager, if you know that you're working at a company and you know that if you have a bad day, there will be a support structure there to keep it in check or to help you out. You know, if you put out something that's maybe not so good, it's not the end of the world because there's plenty of other assets, or maybe there's someone proofreading it, or maybe, you know, a bunch of different other things. You know, there's someone who's actually checking and expecting it. You will feel a lot more confident in doing your work, and you'll feel more confident to take risks and to try to go for something bigger because you know that, hey, if I try something bigger and I fail a little bit, it's not so much of a big deal, because the expectations aren't always be average or always be 100%. It's okay to take that risk. At the same time, if someone expects nothing from you and they're micromanaging you, you're gonna get really, really annoyed and demotivated. I'm sure you've felt one of these things before, right? So give people headroom, to take risks and to excel and to have a support structure to fall back on so that it's not 50%, but it's like 30% or 25% or maybe 35% depending on the situation. But of course, don't go too low. That's expectations, guys. And if you have good, experiment with different expectations yourself, because it makes such a difference. A lot of people just need to make their expectations better. I mean, even something like YouTube or promoting your brand or something, a lot of people, clients will come to me and they'll expect certain things that are just way out of scope or just wrong or just bad, which ruins the entire project because the entire project is geared towards hitting a certain target and that target is just bad. Therefore, the entire project fails only because someone had a bad expectation at the start. I'm going on now. I'm rambling on because it's actually as I'm speaking, I'm thinking of even more crazy examples of how just a perfectly good project with great staff and great people. I'm not thinking of any specific one for anyone watching. Just gets ruined because of one bad expectation. One bad expectation. So sad. So keep your expectations in check. And that's that. If you want to see more, then I'm trying to put out at least a video a week. I want to make sure that I actually have a good, solid thing to say, a good idea before I put out a video. So if it's tomorrow, because I come up with a better idea, it'll be tomorrow. If it's 5 days, if it's a week, then it'll be a week, you know? But you can always talk to me on my Discord. You can talk with all the other people, wonderful people in our community on my Discord. It's linked down below. And sometimes I post stuff on Twitter that's like not enough for a video, but something I want to talk about. So yeah, and then I would really like to stream on Twitch as well. I just don't know what I could possibly do. I don't know. I'm just not really a big streamer or even Twitch watcher. So sometimes I don't really know what people want to see in a stream. Like, what game would I play? Obviously Overwatch, but I'm not going to play like only Overwatch all the time. So yeah, I'll think about it. You think about it. Let me know. And never forget to stay positive. And have a great day. See you next time.